can you win $32,000 on the turn of a card? Right here on Card Sharks. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you. Oh, nice kid. Good looking kid. Thank you. Thank you very much. Whoa. The meter is off the dial here. Hello. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks. Welcome to you at home, especially. Thank you for taking time out of a busy day to join us right here. This is the show where you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card, and to see to it that our Card Sharks get a fair deal. Here are our ladies right now. Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Weir. Nice looking bit. Hello.
Hi. Did I see you drooling before the show today?
I was drooling a bit. I was drooling a bit. We have our models with us today. Anyway, deal out those cards, ladies. We're in the midst of a game right now, and I think it's time for us to meet our players. Here come our Card Sharks right now. Hello, Risha.
Hello, Bill.
Nice to see you.
Very nice to be back.
Wearing another nice sweatshirt.
Absolutely. One of my famous sweatshirts for good luck. It's done pretty good so far.
Yesterday, the other day you had on kitties.
Yeah, kitties and gingerbread men. Today we're going with painting bears.
Painting bears.
Yeah, we'll use anything to be lucky at this point. We've got a tough challenger here.
Tell the folks a little bit about yourself.
My name is Risha Golby, and I was born in British Columbia, Canada, but I now live in beautiful Marina Del Rey, so I exchanged one nice place for another.
That is nice down in Marina. That really is. Are you a singles bar person?
Not anymore, although I am single currently, but I'm not hanging out in the bars too much
these days.
I'm working hard. I'm a business analyst.
You're trying to make some money today. You've already made $1,350, am I correct? Yes, nice. A little bit of change there for some sweatshirts. And here is our challenger, and Maury is ahead by one game right now. Hello, Maury Gersh.
How are you, Bill?
Tell the folks about yourself, sir.
Yesterday I talked about myself, so could I talk about my two hobbies today?
Sure, go ahead.
My wife, Ruth, and I are both life masters of the American Contract Bridge League.
Oh.
An organization of 200,000 members, in which we are ranked among the top 500.
Oh, God, I thought you were going to name all 200,000 for me, Maury. I got a little nervous here.
And in my opinion, she is the world's second best player.
Who's the world's first, Maury?
Oh, there are several thousand tied for first. She's second.
She's second.
You wonder why I'm nervous? I have a world champion.
Did you cut your cards backstage, Maury?
I did.
You did. I want to wish you good luck. I want to wish Risha good luck. We're in the middle of a game right now. We're in the second game where I'm going to ask the second question. As you can see, Maury's got a little bit of a lead right now. Not a big change going on. Risha is going to be hopefully getting to those cards and making some ground up. Let's get right to it. Here is our question, and it goes to Risha. We surveyed 100 men who have been divorced 3 times, and we asked them, can't you take a hint? Come on, fellas, give it up, will you? No. We asked them, did you invite any of your ex-wives to your last wedding?
Oh.
How many divorced men said they did invite an ex-wife to their last wedding?
In actual fact, I can speak from real personal here. My husband, I was his fourth wife.
Fourth?
Yes, I was his fourth wife, and he and his previous wives and I were all very good friends. So he would have invited them, except we eloped. Did you want the rest of the story of my life? Anyway.
Did you know he was married 4 times before you married him?
3 times, yes, I did.
You did, okay. So, I mean, is it like a used car? Do you take him in for a checkup? I mean, what do you do?
No, you hope that they've improved with experience.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, obviously, as I'm divorced now, what can I say?
What can you say? Well, you had it. I guess it didn't come as too much of a surprise. You must have kept one bag packed, I would imagine.
So, at all times, 24 hours a day.
How many divorced men said they did invite an ex-wife to their last wedding?
I don't imagine too many would have been as terrific as my ex-husband, so I would say 37.
37. Maury? Higher, lower?
Well, not having been divorced, I don't know. But if I was divorced, I'd want to get rid of her once and for all. I wouldn't invite her to anything, so it has to be lower.
You're going lower. The actual number. The actual number of divorced men who invited an ex-wife to their last wedding is 3. It is lower. It is lower.
Okay.
Maury goes to the board. Change that 7 if you want, Maury.
Let's change it.
Let's change it. That 7 now becomes an 8.
Oh.
You're going. What are we doing, Maury?
Higher.
He's going higher than an 8. A 5. No, not a lot of help there, Maury. Risha, you get a free shot at the cards, but you must play off this card, as you know. This is a 7.
All right, I'm going higher than a 7.
Higher than a 7. A jack.
Lower than a jack.
Lower than a jack. A deuce.
Higher than a two.
Higher than the two, an ace.
Lower than the ace.
Lower than the ace, and she's going to tie it up. Yes. Champ.
Yes.
Well, very good. Very good. Way to go. Congratulations, Risha.
Thank
you just
you.
Won one game. You've got $100 in your
Thank
pocket.
You.
First player, of course, who wins two games, they win the match. They go on to the money cards, and we are going to be playing our tiebreaker right now. And Suzanne is dealing out those cards. We play, that's a three-card game, maximum of three questions. And, ooh, this is the moment we have all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our audience polling question. And this involves 10 models from the Wilhelmena Agency. Come on up, ladies. Yeah. Ooh. Lordy, lordy. My mercy. That is one. I could hold on this shot for about 25 more minutes, I think. I could watch this. These are our 10 models, again, from the Wilhelmena Agency. And this question, of course, Maury. Maury, look over here, Maury. Maury, this question goes to you, sir. Before the show, we asked these 10 models, have you ever dated a celebrity? How many of these 10 models have dated a celebrity?
Well, why shouldn't they date celebrities? If I was a celebrity, I'd enjoy their company. I think at least seven have.
Seven? Higher, lower, Risha?
Well, there's no question they're in a business where they would get to meet a lot of celebrities, but I think it would be a fewer, a little lower than seven.
You're going a little lower than seven. Audience agrees. Audience agrees. I'm going to go on the high side mainly because they're in a glamorous business. They meet glamorous people. That's how I'm going on this. I'm going high on this one. Anyway, the actual number of these models who have dated a celebrity is eight. It is eight. It is higher. It isn't lower. Again, I was right. Of course, discretion is the better part of valor here. I will not question these ladies as to what celebrities they have dated, but I want to thank them for their participation. They're going to be with us all week, by the way, so they're going to be here all week. We're going to keep them, as a matter of fact, for the whole show. Go ahead. We'll see you in a bit. Thank you, ladies. All right, Maury, you were right. Let's take a look at the card. We've got a nine.
Let's change it.
Going to change that nine. That nine now becomes a six.
Higher.
Higher than a six. An eight. You can freeze, protect your position. What do you want to do?
I'll go with the audience. Lower.
He's going lower. I love Maury. Maury's a gutsy card player. Lower than an eight. If he is right, it is the match to Maury. If he is wrong, Risha gets a free shot at the cards. Lower than an eight. No! Back we go. Risha gets a free shot at the cards. She has to play off this nine.
Lower than a nine.
Lower than a nine. A jack. Didn't happen. Didn't happen. Over we go. I'm going to ask our next question. However, I would like you folks to come back right after this commercial message, and then I will back. So we'll be right back.
Hey, I'm Beachbody Super Trainer Autumn Calabrese, and I'm about to do one of my own workouts right here at home on my TV with Beachbody On Demand, and I'm inviting you to do it with me for free. It's just so easy with Beachbody On Demand. I can choose my workout, push play, and without thinking about it, I get a great workout done in about a half hour without ever leaving the house. And I believe in this so much that if you're one of the first 10,000 people this week who text the code below to 303030, I'll text you back your own free membership to Beachbody On Demand so you can stream all of my workouts right to your smartphone, computer, and your TV for free. You can do the 21-day fix. These simple, easy-to-follow 30-minute workouts are perfect for beginners. You can lose up to 15 pounds in just 3 weeks. Or you can take it up a notch with the 21-Day Fix Extreme. If you're looking for a longer program, you should try 80-Day Obsession. It's great for burning off your belly, shaping your booty, and getting a total body transformation. I mean, look at these results. Now, if you want to do something a little lighter and fun, try Country Heat. That's my easy-to-follow, calorie-burning cardio dance program. Yes, she lost over 60 pounds dancing. Or to really sculpt your physique, try the Master's Hammer and Chisel to train like I do for a fitness competition. I mean, check out her abs. What? Right there alone is over $800 of my fitness programs that you can try for free. But wait, Text me right now, and I'll also show you how to make over 200 delicious recipes for my Fix 8 cooking show and still lose weight. That is an additional $40 value included for free. So if you want to be one of the 10,000 people this week to get instant access to all of my fitness and nutrition programs for free, text HOME to 303030. That's HOME to 303030, and I'll see you on Beachbody On Demand.
In the 21st century, a shopper will exist like no other, and this shopper will be called the Sweepinator. They will be powerful, versatile, and indestructible. They will have only one mission: to search for the manager special and run wild in the aisles. The Sweepinator, only on Supermarket Sweep, weeknights at 9. Sweepinators, your future is in their hands.
Welcome back. We got an exciting game going on right now. We're in the middle of our tiebreaker, and let's get on with it. Here's our second question. Goes to Risha. We surveyed 100 business executives who are the heads of the largest companies across the country, and we asked them, are you a woman? How many top business executives are women?
Interesting, because I work in business. I'm quasi-executive. Heads, though. We're talking really top.
Top of the ladder.
Top. And you 100.
That's the number we use.
All right. A surprising large number from a historic point of view, 37.
You're going 37.
37.
Maury, lower, higher, what do you think?
Well, I really think that while women are okay, let them be the head, there aren't that many, though. Lower.
You're going lower than 37. Crowd agrees. The actual number of top executives who are women is 2. It is lower. And significantly lower. That's not very encouraging, is it? No, not at all. Anyway, Maury, here's a 6.
Let's change that.
Okay. We got an ace.
Lower.
He's going lower than an ace. A
5. Higher.
Higher than a 5 for the game and the match. No. Back we go again. Risha, you're back with your 9. You got to work off the 9 right now.
Lower than the 9 again.
Lower than a 9. We've got a 10. Ah, yes. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, to that part of the game that I love the most. I get to say it is now sudden death. Sudden death. This is our third and final question. Control of the board here is most important. The game must be won on this next play of the cards. Maury, this one is for you, sir. We surveyed 100 teenage boys who are going steady, and we asked them, since you've been going steady, have you cheated on your girlfriend? How many teenage boys admitted they have cheated?
You know how long it's been since I've been a teenager? Sixty years. How many?
I don't know, Maury. It's your show.
I would say about 55.
55. You're going right in the middle. Okay, what do you say, Risha?
I don't know in teenage boys what constitutes cheating. I mean, buying somebody else a soda or what?
I don't
what?
Know, yeah.
Not defined.
Maybe, you know, not sharing the right album with them. I don't know. What are we doing?
You know, strangely, I think that boys in their teens, the first time they go steady, it's a real locked-in love affair. I think it's going to be lower than 55.
You're on lower than 55?
Yeah.
Take a look at this. The actual number of teenage boys who have cheated on their girlfriend is 23. It is lower. Very good. Now, Risha. It's sudden death. You have a decision to make.
I know.
It's sudden death. You can change this card and play on, but if you make a mistake, Maury automatically becomes the winner, or you can force Maury to play off the ace. Not a great decision to make.
This is pretty tough. With an ace, I'm going to change my card and take my own chance.
Yeah, I think you made the right decision.
Yeah.
She's going to change her card right now and play on. Let's take a look at it right now. It is sudden death time. We've got a 6.
Higher than a 6.
A 6, and that means that Maury is our winner.
Oh, unbelievable.
That was tough, but you made the right decision. You had to make that decision. You had to make it. Anyway, you were forced. He was playing off the ace, only 2 cards to go. Thank you so much, Risha, for being here.
Thank you.
You have $1,450, and our thanks again for being here on Card Sharks. We'll see you later.
Thank you so much.
Maury.
Okay, Risha.
Come on, Maury. Come on out here. What a player.
Don't believe that.
Yeah. Maury's here. Maury's going to be playing the money cards when we come right back after this commercial message. Way to go.
Hi, I'm Amy Simon. What if I told you you could instantly get rid of bags and dark circles under your eyes and get amazing results like these? Well, today we're going to show you what everyone on social media is buzzing about. It's called Derma RPX, and our anti-aging skincare expert Leslie Nufusi says this is the one you have to have.
Thank you, Amy. Before I say a word, I'm going to let the real results speak for themselves. Look how the sagging, the bags, and even the dark circles are no longer there.
So what's the secret?
It's not just one, but a breakthrough combination of skin-tightening minerals that actually diminish the bags, cover the dark circles, and tighten the skin, all in as little as 5 minutes.
I was so surprised. I mean, the first time I looked at the picture, I was like, it looks like me 15 years ago. And it works. Works exactly as they say.
I've been looking for something for years that would do that.
I went back like 20 years. I need to start using it.
And you can use Derma RPX for fine lines, wrinkles, crow's feet, and forehead lines. Plus, it's perfect for a more youthful looking neck and décolleté.
Okay, and we do this before or after makeup?
On clean, dry skin, and then you can apply your makeup over it. It will actually help your makeup go on smoother because there's no caking under the eyes.
Call or go online to get your 1 month supply of Derma RPX for the special introductory price of just $19.99. We're so sure that Derma RPX will be the best wrinkle removal cream that you've ever used that it comes with a 90-day money-back guarantee. But to make this the best wrinkle removing offer on TV, we're going to double it and give you a second month supply of Derma RPX absolutely free. And here's the best part. We'll ship it to you free. You get a 2 month supply of Derma RPX and free shipping. An incredible offer.
To order, call 1-800-210-4266. That's 1-800-210-4266. Or order online at buydermarpx.com.
Welcome back. We got Maury here. He's our new champ. He is our Bridge Master player. Let me quickly tell you how we're going to play the money cards right now. Susanna and Lacey are dealing out the cards you've already cut backstage. We're going to give you some new money to bet with. $200 on the bottom line. You bet your way across the board by calling high and low. When you get to that second line, we're going to give you an additional $400 of betting money. You must bet at least $50 on each card until you get to the top. That's the big bet, where you must wager at least half your dollars. Now, don't forget, we're going to give you an opportunity to change one card per line from one of the spare cards that Lacey is dealing out over there. That's all there is to it. Are you ready to go, Maury?
Ready.
Good for you. Let's give Maury $200. He's got it.
Okay, thank you.
Maury, you play your cards right, you can play $200 and turn it into $32,000.
Right.
Let's do it. Let's look at this base card. We got an ace.
Wow.
All of it lower. A five. Way to go. $400, Maury.
100 higher.
100 higher than a five. If it's another five, you know it's a push. No win, no loss. We go on. 100 higher than a five. A nine. $500, Maury, on the nine.
100 lower.
You can change it if you want.
Oh, yeah. Let's change that one.
Okay.
One.
Okay, card number one. Let's take a look at it right now. That nine now becomes a jack. Good way, Maury. 500 on the jack.
200 lower.
200 lower than a jack. A king. $300. We're bringing your king up here. We're going to give you $400 additional betting money. You now have $700. You're off a king.
500 lower.
500 lower than a king. A three. $1,200. 1,200.
1,000 higher.
1,000 higher than a three. Be there. Yes!
Whoa!
A king! $2,200 on the king, Maury.
2,000 lower.
2,000 lower. Do you ever bet 2,000 on a card, Maury?
Yes!
Yeah. 2,000 lower than a king. Yes!
Whoa!
4,200. This is your base card.
Let's change it.
You gonna change it?
Two.
Okay. That 10 now becomes a six. Now, Maury, you must wager at least $2,100 on the six.
Well, 2,100 higher.
You're going 2,100 higher. Be there. Let's get some money for Maury here. Higher than a six. Yes! Way to go! $6,300, Maury. $6,300. Terrific! You're a player.
Oh,
absolutely. We'll be back with my new pal, Maury, right after this. We're going to have a lot more fun. Stick around.
Have you or a loved one taken Zantac or another heartburn medication and developed cancer? You may be entitled to compensation. The FDA just announced that it is requesting manufacturers withdraw from the market all prescription and over-the-counter ranitidine heartburn medications, commonly known by the brand name Zantac. This is the latest step in an ongoing investigation of a contaminant known as NDMA in ranitidine heartburn medications. NDMA is a chemical that the FDA and World Health Organization both classify as cancer-causing. Now, prior to this announcement, CVS and Walgreens pulled Zantac from their shelves, citing the link between Zantac, NDMA, and cancer. If you or a loved one have taken Zantac or another heartburn medication and developed cancer, how do you fight for the compensation you deserve? You choose the right legal team that has the experience, support staff, and resources to seek the most compensation for your injuries. Call for more information and a free case review.
Hi, I'm Jesse.
And I'm Ben.
We started Hubble because contact lenses are too expensive. At Hubble, our fresh daily contacts are affordable and delivered straight to you.
Get your first 2 weeks free at HubbleContacts.com.
BingoBilly.net is the fastest growing online bingo community where you can play free games, meet great new friends, and have fun. The best part is, it's totally free. Bingo Billy is everywhere.
I think it's time for us to meet Debbie. Come on, Deb. Hiya, Debbie.
Hi.
Tell the folks a little something about yourself.
Well, my name is Debbie Sullivan, and I'm married. I have four children, and I work full-time for my husband.
You do?
Yes.
Well, with four children, you would work full-time. Absolutely.
Yes.
Well, we wish you good luck. You've already cut your cards backstage.
Yes, I did.
Let's get started with our game. First question is our audience polling question, ladies and gentlemen. Again, we're going to get a chance to look at those 10 beautiful models we brought in this week. Come on up here, ladies. Maury, this question's for you, sir.
All right.
Before the show, we asked these 10 models, when you look in the mirror, do you think you're too fat? How many of these 10 models do think they're too fat?
Gotta be kidding.
I just read them, Maury. I don't write them, I'll tell you.
There aren't any fat ones there. And, I don't think any of them should think they're fat. But if they do, I would say two at the most.
Two. You're going two. Debbie, what do you think, higher or lower?
Oh, Maury is absolutely right. They're all gorgeous, every single one of them. But girls always have that problem of thinking they're a little fatter than they are. So I just have to go maybe a little bit higher.
Okay. I'm going with Deb. I know, this is their business. They want to look their best at all times. And I know I'm going to say that a lot of them probably think they're too fat. Let's take a look at the answer, though. The actual number of these models who think they're too fat is 9. It is 9. Yes, it is higher. So we went with the odds. Who is the one that doesn't think she's too fat? Who is it? You look terrific. You know, do you have to watch what you eat, though?
To keep it up.
Yeah. To keep your weight up?
Yes.
Oh, you're one of those rotten people eat anything you want, right? Oh, I don't like you already. So you can just go over to the deli and get a big sandwich and everything, right? Ooh.
All the women.
There it is. All right. Thank you so much, ladies. Have a seat. Thank you. Okay, here we go. Debbie, here's your base card. Change it if you like. A king.
All right. Lower.
Lower than a king.
Woo.
5. Higher than a 5, a 7.
Okay, let's freeze.
Gonna freeze. Good decision. That's right in the middle. Let's take a look at our next question. This one goes for you, Debbie.
Okay.
We surveyed 180-year-old men, and we asked them, do you think that rock star Madonna is sexy? How many 80-year-old men said Madonna is sexy?
I have a problem believing a lot of 80-year-old men will know who Madonna is. I don't think that's real high. I'll say 20.
Maury, what do you think? You know who Madonna is?
I've seen maybe a couple of times. Yeah. I don't even know what he does. Is he sings or dance or what? Yeah.
It's kind of hard to figure out, yeah.
But even then, if I don't think he's sexy, I don't think a lot of men.
You're entitled to your opinion, Maury, whatever you think here.
But as long as she says 20?
20.
See, the odds are, yeah. I'd say higher.
You're going higher, huh?
Just because of the odds.
Yeah. How old are you, Maury?
77.
77. You were a little young for that survey, I think. The actual number of 80-year-old men who said Madonna is sexy is 28. It is.
Bill, you're not going to tell him who Madonna is, are you?
Maury, go to the record store, pick up an album, check it out for me.
Are you kidding?
Here it is. Here's your base card, Maury. Okay. Take a look at this. It's a 4.
Higher.
He's going higher than a 4. 3. Ooh. Okay, that means that, Debbie, you get a free shot at the cards. Have to play off the 7.
Okay, higher than 7.
Higher than a 7. A 10.
Lower than the 10.
Lower than the 10.
Lower than a 10.
For game number 1, lower than a 10. It is lower than a 10. Way to go. Way to go. All right, you've got $100 on your side of the board. We'll be right back with game number 2 and some pictures of Madonna right after this.
Disposable masks are now a limited commodity. That's because you usually need a new one every day, which can make them scarce and hard to get. Introducing Copperware Reusable Mask. It's a reusable, machine-washable mask with the properties of copper. Real copper threads are woven into the fabric using fiber matrix copper technology. The best news is Copperware Reusable Masks are available now. You can even get them delivered straight to your door, so you can obey shelter-at-home orders and practice social distancing. These are reusable copper-infused protective masks using breakthrough fiber matrix copper technology. The secret is that copper threads are woven right into the fabric to create a washable mask with the properties of copper. It can help reduce facial touching and covers your nose, mouth, and face. Sometimes we have to go out in public to get essentials. The copper-infused mask can create separation between your face, mouth, and nose and the world outside. And it's all woven into a comfortable, breathable mask with the properties of copper. They're comfortable to wear all day long, cool and easy to breathe, and designed to fit anyone. Great for around the house, working outside, or anytime you want to cover up your nose and mouth. Disposable masks usually need to be replaced daily. That can add up, and they can get scarce. Copperware reusable masks are machine washable, so you can use them day after day. Call or go online now and order your Copperware reusable mask now for only $29.99. But wait, order now and you can double your offer and get a second mask free. Just pay separate processing and handling. That's 2 Copperware reusable masks for only $29.99. Get a comfortable mask with the properties of copper. Order your Copperware reusable masks now.
To order, call 1-800-706-4816. That's 1-800-706-4816 or go to copperwaremask.com.
Some of our departing contestants will receive Concord's AW900 35mm automatic camera with focus 3 lens pop-up flash and the pocket-size 110 TEF with built-in tele-lens and flash from Concord Camera. Conair, you can be confident if it's Conair, a world leader in personal care appliances. Conair's latest innovations, hot sticks, fashion plates, and thermosel cordless appliances. Charbroil electric grill, easy to clean up, smoky barbecue taste that makes outdoor cooking a flavorful experience. Ideal where open flames are restricted from Charbroil. Harvest Saver dehydrator, preserves delicious fruits and vegetables, makes rich creamy yogurt, grows salad sprouts, and makes fruit roll-ups, furnished by Harvest Saver. A gift certificate from Graylon Sightseeing Tours. While on vacation, let Graylon show it like it is all over the world. Fast, effective Cutex remover. It actually locks in moisture, so your nails get stronger every time you use it. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.